In this video, we're going to talk about why a negative times a negative is a positive. So let's start off with the following observation. As we know, 0 is equal to 2 times 0. And the reason is because 0 times anything is always 0. Now what we're going to do is we're going to rewrite 0 in kind of a creative way. So what we're going to do is write 0 as 1 plus negative 1. Wouldn't you agree that 1 plus negative 1 is equal to 0? So you'll see why we're going to do this in a second. So that 0 I'm just going to write as 1 plus negative 1. Okay, so now 2 is being multiplied by this sum, right? 1 plus negative 1. And anytime you have a number multiplied by a sum, we know that you can distribute that number on the outside. So for example, I can take 2 and I can multiply it by 1, and then I can take 2 and multiply it by negative 1. So let's do that. 2 times 1, and then 2 times negative 1. So this is equal to 2 multiplied by 1 plus, and now when I distribute the 2, I get a 2 times negative 1. So at this stage, well, 1 times anything is just that number. So 1 times 2 is equal to 2. And then plus, now the question is, what is 2 times negative 1? Now before you answer that, notice that in the very beginning, you know, all of these are equal to 0. Why? Because the original one was equal to 0. So the 0 hasn't changed on the left-hand side. That is, 0 is equal to this, and so 0 is equal to that, and then 0 is equal to that, and then 0 is also equal to this final line right here. So if we think about that for a minute, it's asking us, 2 plus what number gives 0? Well, there's only one number such that when we add it to 2, we'll get 0. And that number, as you know, is negative 2. So 2 plus negative 2 is how we're going to get 0. So let me write a negative 2 right here. And the reason that's significant is because what it's telling us is this. 2 multiplied by negative 1 is equal to negative 2. Because after all, 2 times 1 is 2. But then 2 times negative 1, we weren't sure what that was, but now I can clearly see that because I have 0 on the left-hand side, 2 times negative 1 had to be negative 2. So let's write that down. 2 times negative 1 is equal to negative 2. So we just said 2 multiplied by negative 1 is equal to negative 2. Okay? Now, multiplication is what we call commutative. That is, you can interchange the order. So 3 times 5 is the same as 5 times 3, or 2 times negative 1 is the same as negative 1 times 2. So negative 1 times 2 is the same as 2 times negative 1, and so negative 1 times 2 must be equal to negative 2. Kind of an interesting property. Negative 1 multiplied by 2 is negative 2. Now let's try that again. But instead of writing 0 as 2 times 0, let's do it again with negative 3. So let's write it now as 0 is equal to negative 3 multiplied by 0. Okay, and these steps are going to look very similar. So what we're again going to do is we're going to write 0 in that creative way. Do you remember what we did over here? We wrote 0 as 1 plus negative 1. Let's do that again over here. So the negative 3 is going to stay as it is, in the same way that 2 didn't change in the very beginning. So the negative 3 remains negative 3, but that 0 gets written in that creative way. 1 plus negative 1. Okay? And just like before, in the previous step, what you can now do is you can, well, over here I distributed that 2. So likewise, I'm going to distribute the negative 3. So here we go. the negative 3 is going to get multiplied by the 1, and the negative 3 is also going to get multiplied by the negative 1. So let's write down what we get. Negative 3 multiplied by 1, and then negative 3 multiplied by negative 1. Okay, so, well, just like before, 1 times negative 3, well, 1 times anything is always that number, right? So 1 times negative 3 is just negative 3. And the question is, what is negative 3 times negative 1? And just like before, what we just said before was that the left-hand side was always 0. So this is 0, that hasn't changed, this is 0, and this is 0. So now I'm asking myself, well, negative 3 plus what must give 0? And you can think about that for a second and come up with 3. That is, negative 3 added to 3 is how you're going to get 0. What does that mean? What that means is that, just like before, negative 3 times negative 1 must be the same as 3. You know, we weren't sure what negative 3 times negative 1 was, but now that we see that because we had 0 on the left-hand side, negative 3 times negative 1 had to be positive 3. Because we're adding this number to negative 3, and the only thing that you can add to negative 3 to get 0 is positive 3. So let's write down what we just observed. Negative 3 times negative 1 gives positive 3. So negative 3 times negative 1 is equal to positive 3. And just like before, what I can do is take advantage of the fact that multiplication is commutative. So I can interchange the order of multiplication. So I can write this, instead of as negative 3 times negative 1, I can write it as negative 1 times negative 3. And negative 1 times negative 3, again, is the same as positive 3. Okay, so at this stage, it's time for an observation. And that observation is as follows. Remember what we did over here. Negative 1 multiplied by 2 gave negative 2. And over here, I see that negative 1 times negative 3 gives positive 3. Now, that's a very interesting feature or property of negative 1. Whenever you multiply negative 1 by a number, what does it do? It causes the sign to change. Negative 1 times positive 2 gave negative 2. And negative 1 times negative 3 gave positive 3. So the key to multiplying two negative numbers lies in that observation. Negative 1 times any number causes the number to change sign, either from a positive to a negative, or from a negative to a positive. So let's go ahead and see why that helps us multiply two negative numbers together. So let's go ahead and multiply the numbers negative 3 and negative 5. Well, I know that I can write negative 3 in this really creative way. Negative 1 multiplied by 3. Does that make sense to you? Isn't negative 1 times 3 equal to negative 3 from what we discussed a moment ago? And if I just leave the negative 5 alone for a minute, now what I can do is take advantage of the fact that multiplication is commutative. That is, I can change the order. So I can write this as 3 times negative 1 times negative 5. Now, what does that bought me? Well, now when I look at this, I say to myself, well, negative 1 times anything causes the number to change sign. So negative 1 times negative 5 is a positive 5. So now that if the 3 is left alone, negative 1 times negative 5 is positive 5. And now I'm left with 3 times 5 is equal to 15. And I see that a negative times a negative gave me a positive. Now, we can also use that property to multiply a negative and a positive together. So, for example, let's say we want to multiply. Let's go with, How about 2 multiplied by negative 3? And if we play the same game, that is, I can write the negative as negative 1 times something else. So let's leave the 2 alone. And wouldn't you agree that negative 3 is the same thing as negative 1 times 3? Let's just double check that. Negative 1 times 3, the effect of the negative 1 is to change the sign of this, and that would make that negative 3. So that's right. But now what I can do is say, well, I can interchange the order of these. And so I'm looking at negative 1 times 2 times 3. And then 2 times 3 is 6. So I'm looking at negative 1 multiplied by 6. And now negative 1 times anything changes the sign. So negative 1 times 6 is negative 6. And my observation now is that a positive times a negative is a negative. So I observed here that a negative times a negative is a positive, and over here that a positive times a negative is a negative. And it all hinges upon the very interesting feature of negative 1, which is that negative 1 times a number is always the negative of the number that you're multiplying. And that's why a negative times a negative is a positive.